Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about something that really does help me during my depression and flare-ups and anxiety and panic attacks, if you will. Somebody that has really just been there for me and helped me out big time, and this video is going to be all about him. Now, for me, I've made a video kind of about like who I am and stuff. If you go ahead and check out my channel, and I kind of talk about how like in 2010 I lost my father. He passed away, and in 2012 I put down one of my dogs. In 2013 I put down my other dog, and at that point, I had been going through a lot of depression and physical flare-ups and stuff, and just really not in a good way. And 2014, you know, I'd been like going through a couple of months of being like depressed and grieving over not having a dog in my life, which was really a sucky time. I hated it. And in 2014, in April, I had been looking at different humane societies websites in my area, and my mom had called me because she had been helping me look online, and she said, you know, you got to go to this humane society, which was where I was living was like 40 minutes away or so, and she said, there's this dog here that you just have to check out, and I want you to take a look at him. And so I went onto the website, and I was like, oh my god, I have to at least go in and look at him. He just looks like the cutest dog ever, and he's actually getting into something right now, but if you hear that snuffling, it's him right on the bed right next to me. But I had gone in, and I was very anxious. I felt like it was kind of meant to be with him, and I just, like, I had to go in, I had to wait, and I had to, I'm gonna grab him real quick. This is him right here. His name is Nigel. He is the cutest thing ever. He is my baby, and it's just been amazing with him. I had to wait for a room so that I could meet him, and there was like every room was full, and there was families ahead of me, and you know, 20 minutes later they said, we don't know where the other families went, there's a room open if you'd like to come and meet him, which obviously I wanted to, and I fell in love. Now this boy had come from New Mexico, where he was abused and left to live out on the streets, and I adopted him the day before his second birthday, or about his second birthday. He actually just this past April, am I keeping you up? This past April, he just turned 5. We just kind of go and celebrate with what they had called his birthday, and he has helped me through so much stuff, and I guess I have helped him with a lot of stuff because he's not as nervous as he was before. Obviously, he still has like trust issues and stuff, but with like other people, if they're new, if he hasn't like dealt with them before, but otherwise he has been pretty good with people. He's pretty calm and laid back. For anybody asking, he is full Chihuahua, and he's about 8 pounds or so, and when I first got him, he didn't have all of that white there, and he is actually sticking out his tongue a little bit because he's got some front teeth missing, and he's pretty cute, aren't ya? And he's my baby, and I just wanted to make a video about this to kind of just like show something that does help me through my depression, tough times. This boy is always crazy and goofy, and he loves to snuggle, and he loves to play and eat. I think eating is one of his favorite things, and going out for walks, and yeah, we're not going right now though. And all sorts of stuff he likes to do, and now he's in a house where he's happy and healthy and not ever having to wonder about whether somebody's going to be mean or anything to him. And I just kind of wanted to share that with everybody and just kind of touch base on the whole depression thing. And I will see you guys in the next video. If you go down, leave me a comment, subscribe, and give me a big thumbs up. It does help. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.